For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now.
After years of reviewing films professionally, I believe I have a pretty high threshold for garbage. But sometimes, oh lordy lord lord, the universe really tests a critic's resolve. Hey guys, my name is Acharita. This is Film Companion. You're watching Not a Movie Review, and right now I am not going to be reviewing Coolie Number One. David Dhawan's near identical reboot of this dated 90s comedy is an offensive, unfunny, atrocious attempt at comedy stuck in a timeline where Jay Kishan becomes Jackson, ladki ka baap sar jhuka ke khada rehta hai, where the only thing a man has to be to qualify as worthy of a woman's love is rich, I suppose. The most annoying thing, though, is that this film is so obtuse, it thinks it's making a statement on classism and hyping dignity of labor by saying our hero is a coolie and his sidekick is a driver and they are two worthy men, worthy of love. Except not once does any rich person, of whom there are many in this film, ever gets told that or recognizes their bias in any way. Perhaps I shouldn't expect too much from a film such as this, but I do expect better choices from a talent like Sara Ali Khan. If someone's telling her she needs to participate in masala vehicles at this point in her career, I'd recommend some more thought. Before the poor actor gets a chance to utter a single dialogue in the film, she's got to prove that she is a Bollywood heroine by dancing on a railway platform while men crowd her, calling her Bhabi. Everything about this movie is exasperating. If you're watching this on Amazon Prime Video, expecting it to be just as bad as you think it will be, dear viewer, let me assure you, it's worse. A Borat impersonating Javed Jafri plays a classist casteist pandit who vows to destroy Paresh Rawal while thinking aloud, aisa dama dhundunga jo teri izzat ki dhajjiyan uda de. Essentially, I'll ruin your daughter's life because you were rude to me and I'm on a high horse about you being an egomaniac. If I caught it right, and I could be wrong, but Varun Dhawan's name appears in the opening credits with a typo. The space between Varun and Dhawan is missing. Now, this could be a new numerology thing or a pretty major error, but it does go to show that I will go to any level to find something to analyze in a film. Any film. Varun Dhawan's brown face washes off every time he steps in a shower, which is a surprising number of times in this film. He says this line, and I quote, plus apologize in advance for repeating it, chinga ponga ping pong chong chong, because he's pretending to be from Singapore. He wears drag, makes fat jokes, is as racist as they come, but flash ki tarah tez bhag sakta hai Raju to save little children jinki taraf green screen par daudti hui khatarnak trains aa rahi hain. Hero-giri ke maine change hone ki umeed mein main 32 saal ki ho gayi. Lekin phir bhi, filmmakers with the most money, means, access and influence are producing trash. Maybe OTT platforms need to start opening their doors to more indie filmmakers. The climax of Coolie Number One takes place in a hospital where there are many signs encouraging organ donation. Good. Where do I sign up for a brain transplant? On a scale of 1 to 10, Coolie Number One is 2 Varun Dhawans appear in the film post-interval, creating confusion ki who is who. Didn't we already watch that film like 3 years ago? And about 20 years before that? Is this through a capsule? Am I in a simulation? I'll tell you what's real. That subscribe button. Dabao usko, test kar lo.